بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In these sessions, we will do a couple of exercises on chapter 10, how to read from files and how to write into files. We will start with the following example. We have to write a Java program to do the following. We have to ask the user to enter student ID and GPA for 30 students. And then our program should save the student data in a file named student.txt. The program needs to save only the data of 2017 students. And we have a hint here that the first four digits of a student ID will represent the enrollment year. So we will read from the keyword. We will ask the user enter ID and GPA. So for example, the student ID 2017, 12345, and then a space 3.5. And similarly, we will read other data. We have to open a file student.txt. The first line, we should write a message 2017 student, and then we have to list the students. We will read 30 students, but we will output only students they are 2017 student. So here we will have to go there. If this student is 2017, and how can we know that this student is 2017? By looking at the first four digit, then we will write the student ID, comma, and then the GPA. For example, the second student is 2016, that's why the data should not be saved in our file. So we will read from a keyboard, ID and GPA, and then we will write into file the ID and the GPA, but we have to write only for 2017 students. So as we discussed in a previous session, when we are dealing with file, always we need a try and catch. So always we will start with the try block. This is to handle any usual event. And once we close the try block, we should have the catch. And we will use IO exception, input output exception. And we will simply output a message of the error of the file. Now let's go step by step how to deal with these files. So what do we need to do? We need to do the following. We have to say print writer out file, a new print writer student.txt. So what we are doing? We are saying we have a student.txt, this is a file, and we will open it as such that any output we need to do the output in this file. We will read from the keyboard, so we will need a scanner as usual. We will call it in file, new scanner system.n. So I'm reading from the keyboard. Now the first message I would like to output in my file is the message 2017. So I need 2017 students colon. So that's why I will say go to out file. So out file is the name of the file we open for writing. So this is the out file. We open it for writing and then we will say out file print line 2017 student. We will output the following message 2017 student. Now we need to ask the user for 30 student. So we need a loop from I equals 0, I less than 30, I plus plus. What do we need to do? We will ask the user, please enter ID and GPA. And then from the keyboard, which we name it as in file, we will read a long value. We will save it in ID. We will read a double value and we will save it in GPA. So the first time we will deal with these values, we will have a variable ID. And the value is 2017, 1234. And we will have a GPA. And the value of the GPA is 3.5. Now we need to take this value and we have to save it in our file. But there is a condition. You should not save it before you just double check that the first four digits are 2017. And the way to do this, we will say, go and divide ID by 10,000. If it is 2017, then we can write the file. So we will divide this number by 10,000, and this will give us the first four digits, because integer over integer is an integer. If it is 2017, go to our out file and do the output of ID, comma, and GPA. So we will go and output the ID, comma, and then GPA. So this is for the first student. Still, we will go with the loop. With the second ID, so we will ask the user for a new ID, we will read the ID, we will read the GPA, so this will be the new value. So we will have here a new student with the new values, and the ID will be 2016-1234, and the GPA is 2.3. Now go and check the ID over 10,000. Is it 2017? When we divide 2016-1234 over 10,000, the result will be 2016, which are the first four digits. So we will not write in the file, and we will go and continue on our loop. So we will continue reading three students, but we will output in a file only those students with 2017. Next, remember that you are opening a file, so you have to close it. So remember out file dot close. So this was the first exercise with files, and here we learned how to open a file for writing, how to read from the keyboard, and then we output in a file. So let's do a recap and just make sure that we know this, the important concepts always we have to have in files. So always in file, remember, you should have a try, you should have catch. With the catch, you have IO exception. If you need to write into file, you have to use a print writer. Give it an object name, and then between double quotation, specify the file name. If you are reading from the keyboard, so usually we just say use a scanner, and we use system.n. Now, because the question was saying you have to read for 30 students, so I should have a loop, and the loop should go from 0 up to 30. Read as usual from the keyboard, output a message, and read the data. And then you have an if condition. If it is 2017, you need to output in the file. And that's why I have to say the file name dot print line. Remember always, before you end catch, you have to close your file. So you have to say your out file dot close. So this is the out file, which was opened for writing, and it will be closed over there.